The landscape here is something else, really. There's just an incredible sense of openness. These massive rolling hills, huge open plains. There's not many places that feel this sense of space. The Mongol Derby is the world's longest and toughest horse race. It's 1,000 kilometres based on Genghis Khan's ancient postal system, where he could get messages to all corners of the empire. The riders are the only things that do 1,000 kilometres, so they change horse every 40 or less kilometres. So the horses are always fresh and the riders are always exhausted.
2, 1, go!
The idea for the Mongol Derby came because I was in Mongolia organising a car rally and then just got to know the culture and got to be out in the countryside with the herders and meet the horses and kind of gradually understand a bit more about it. And we were looking at launching a horse race. Setting up the first one was quite a challenge, partly because we were wading into a whole world of unknown. So it took a long time travelling around the countryside, speaking to the herders, speaking to historians, speaking to equestrians, working out how we could structure the rules to ensure the animal safety in this kind of changing and different environment. The Derby has over 500 people helping to run the event, and the vast majority of those are local herders. So we travel down the course many times before the race actually takes place. First of all, to find the kind of general course structure that will enable us to get the support network working. And then after that, we then revisit at the right time of year when we know the herders will be in their summer locations. And then we meet the families that will host the horse stations and talk to them about the race. We're staying in their homes and we're borrowing their horses from them. So they are the kind of very backbone of the race. Horse holds a very spiritually important place in Mongolian culture. They're a ridiculously tough animal, they're very fast, they're very different to other animals, and I think that combination of both that massive landscape, these unusual horses and the rich culture that's so tied into the animals themselves makes the race quite different to anything else. Come into each horse station, the riders choose their own horses. We try and stand back and let them make that choice. Partly it's a very personal thing, I think. That interaction they have with the horse and the bond they form over the ride that they're about to do. The people who look after their horses better generally do much better than those who are too competitive in the kind of traditional, going, I'm just going to go fast and get to the end. There's some that are more wild than others, and I think the person's temperament and the horse's temperament need to kind of match.
Come on, boy. Come on, choo.
I think what makes it hard for the riders is a few things. It's partly the exposure that they're outside for 10 days, but it's more that it's sheer exhaustion over time, riding from 6 a.m. to 8 o'clock at night every day, day in, day out, takes its toll. The first Mongol Derby was a joint win by a Mongolian and a South African guy who rode together across the finish line, which was really nice to see. The most memorable moment was watching the last rider come in, more or less unscathed. I won't forget that for a while.